It's a pleasure to follow the Honourable Gentleman for North Cornwall, not least because I was the Minister for Schools when we introduced the London Challenge, and it's worth reminding the House that prior to the London Challenge, London schools were performing less well than the national average, despite being better funded than the national average. It wasn't simply a consequence of London Challenge, but he's right to speak up for rural and coastal schools, and I think the suggestion of a coastal challenge similar to the London Challenge is a very welcome one, and one that I would be delighted to give my support to. Investment in education is crucial for social justice, for tackling inequality and poverty, and of course for our national economic future. When Labour took office in 1997, UK public spending on education as a proportion of GDP was at its lowest level since the early 1960s. We lagged behind many of our European neighbours and other advanced economies. Yet by 2010, we'd overtaken key countries like Germany, Switzerland and Australia, delivering real change with smaller class sizes, modern school buildings, higher per pupil funding and a big increase in the numbers of both teachers and support staff. Yet since 2010, that progress has been reversed. Education spending as a share of national income has fallen from 5.8% to 4.3%. That is a shocking decline in our national investment in education. In Liverpool, the council expects 16 schools that are currently in surplus to go into deficit and 24 schools that already have deficits to go further into deficit. And despite the funding challenges that schools face across my constituency, the situation would be much worse if it wasn't for the pupil premium. The pupil premium was a welcome initiative introduced by the Coalition aimed at improving opportunities for children from the poorest backgrounds. Yet, as we've heard from others today, head teachers are increasingly saying to me that they have no alternative but to use pupil premium cash to offset budget cuts elsewhere. The head of St Margaret's Anfield Church of England Primary School told me this week, without pupil premium, I would be unable to deliver an effective curriculum and a safe working environment. I'm particularly concerned that children who most need extra support are bearing the brunt of changes. The head of St Paul's and St Timothy's Catholic Infant School told me, it is the most vulnerable children in our schools who are suffering the most as a result of this funding crisis. And I want to echo what the Right Honourable Gentleman from Wokingham said about high needs funding. According to analysis by IPPR, in the northwest of England, funding per eligible child through the high needs block has fallen in the last 5 years by 24%, a quarter cut in the funding per pupil in the high needs block. And in Liverpool, they're forecasting a budget deficit in that block of more than £3 million. A great school in my constituency, Bankview High School, is a special school for students with complex learning difficulties. It's seen an increase in its number of pupils from 160 to 200. Next door is Redbridge High School, which caters for children with severe learning difficulties and profound and multiple learning disabilities. They've also experienced increasing number of pupils, yet they don't have the funding to match this demand. As a result, the head tells me they've had to cut... Yes, of course, I'll give way. Yeah.
And will you agree one of the fundamental points which I've raised with the Minister on a number of occasions is too much of the funding does not reach the schools. It gets stuck somewhere on the way. We've got to make sure that funding is in the schools. Will you agree with that?
I agree with that. And despite the challenging environment both these schools face, I'm delighted that both Bankview and Redbridge have again been ranked outstanding by Ofsted. And can I take this opportunity to congratulate both schools on this fantastic achievement? Schools in Liverpool are highly dependent on the minimum funding guarantee, yet that has not been confirmed beyond 2021. As the chair of the Select Committee rightly said, schools need long-term certainty. Yet another head has raised the issue of having to put forward three-year budget plans without confirmation of future funding arrangements due to the delay in the comprehensive spending review. Surely the message of this debate today is that education deserves the same kind of long-term planning that we are seeing for our health system. I want to finish by thanking all the teachers and support staff who work so hard. They go above and beyond. The head teacher of Clifford Holroyd School, Jane Pepper, said, I spend large amounts of my time seeing how we can do more with less, applying for grants to keep us afloat and even selling Christmas trees to try to generate funding. The burden should not be on head teachers like Jane to do that. The government needs to ensure that as it expects more from our schools, it backs this up with significant increases in funding and resources. We need, Madam Deputy Speaker, a serious long-term settlement for schools funding.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah. Bruce. Primary and secondary schools.